doesn't belong in the chicken coop? Everybody's always curious. Even about Smash Pumpkins.
Hi everyone, I'm Tara from Wild Bird Farm. I grow here in central Iowa in Zone 5, and while I love eucalyptus, I have yet to get it to overwinter here, even with some extra protection. I've had success growing several varieties, starting them from seed. I've found that they like to be on the dry side as seedlings, with bottom watering as needed and bumping up into larger containers as their roots show through the bottom. Planting out here in late May generally gives me a good harvest come September and October. And while we've had a warm fall, the temperatures are about to dip and I need to get some protection around these first year plants. I feel absolutely blessed. We have such a gorgeous day to get some work done outside. So today we're going to be prepping the eucalyptus in hopes of overwintering them, both outside and inside the hoop house, assuming we have enough. So we bought these straw bales, and this is gonna be our main protection. We are going to line the single row of eucalyptus with the straw and heavily mulch at the roots. But the first thing I need to do is trim down some of the eucalyptus stems. They get smaller as you go down. It's kind of hard to see them. I did start to rake some extra mulch over them, but this is the one on the end. And then you kind of just have to wiggle your way down and find the base. So I'm gonna be chopping a lot of these down. And then the largest one is probably the diameter of a quarter. And that's this one. And this one is also gonna get chopped down. And I'm obviously gonna need bigger pruners than these for this guy. I'm gonna use some loppers, I guess. I'm not sure the proper name for them. So let's get started. If you've been around here for a while, you know that I tried something similar last winter and didn't have success. So these are the things I'm doing differently. First of all, the eucalyptus was planted in a single row this year. That's going to allow us to keep the bales very close together and even top the bale row with more straw to try and keep that insulation and keep that ground from freezing. That's our goal here. I think if we can keep the ground from freezing, keep the roots of the eucalyptus from freezing hard in the ground, we will hopefully have success with some of these. I used leaves to mulch last year, and I'm using wood bark this year. I'm hoping that's a better insulator. I'm gonna pretty much cover the bottom of the eucalyptus with that. The stump that I leave after I cut off, I'm gonna mulch that very heavily. We also tried to put plastic over the wider row last year with the straw bales, and that blew off about halfway through our winter. So we're hoping by topping it with the straw bale rather than using plastic, that's gonna be a better insulator all around. So I'm just finding the base and I'm coming up for some of the very small branches, I'm just gonna trim them off. For the leader branch, or trunk, I guess you would say, I'm gonna leave anywhere from 9 to 18 inches, probably closer to 9 to 12. And I'm just gonna go down the line here and do that to each one. And I have several eucalyptus videos. I will add links down in the description. I have from last year when I tried to do this, and also planting out, harvest, all kinds of things. So if you're interested in growing eucalyptus in cold climates, you might wanna check some of those out.
show you a few examples close up here. Here is the base of one. You can kind of see it has several branches. And I chop those down, I'd say about 6 to 9 inches. And then when I come back with the tree mulch, this entire crown is gonna get covered. Here's another example. This is a nice size one, so if we dig down, you can see the branch, the leader here. And I'm gonna leave this one. This is a good 12, 14 inches. And again, we're gonna mulch really heavily right here. So I'm gonna go grab the loppers for the last 3 or 4. You
ready to tackle the larger trunks? Two steps. I think I'm going to line with the straw bales first and then bring down the mulch. And of course our wheelbarrow had its wheel get broken, so I will be carrying the mulch down in buckets. That's usually the way things go. Luckily straw isn't very heavy, even though you'll probably hear me huffing and puffing a bit. Growing up on a farm, I have moved many a straw bale in my day. Before, I have an absolutely gorgeous day to do this work. But looking at the 10-day forecast in the next 5 or 6 days, we're gonna have highs in the 30s and lows in the 20s. So I figured it was time I get this done. Thinking the roots of the eucalyptus aren't coming out wider than a straw bale on their first year. So I'm just trying to cozy them up. I would say there's about a foot in between these two rows of straw. They're never far away. Alright, so this is kind of what the straw trench, I guess we'll call it, looks like. And again, the plan is we may need to snug these a little closer because we're planning to put the straw bales across the top after I get mulch filled in the trench, which is the next step. Alright, this is my make-do wheelbarrow. If it takes too many of these, I may wait till the wheelbarrow's fixed. I guess it's a good cardio workout. Okay, another couple trips. We have everything covered. Remember, these down here at this end are a little taller, so we've got this still sticking up. We've got this one down here covered. And I'm gonna call
few more loads once I get my wheelbarrow fixed. And then again, we'll top this with a layer, kind of a cap, a lid of straw, if you will, to completely enclose this and hopefully insulate those roots in the soil. And very similar as to what I did outside in the hoop house, I brought in mulch and carefully mulched and heavily mulched the crown of the eucalyptus plants. And then I have some short pieces of rebar. These get pounded into the ground. And then these blue hoops, I'll get this one off to show you, will slide onto the rebar. And then the frost cloth will run down the length of the eucalyptus over the hoops. So I am going to do that down the entire center. It looks like last year's hoops down at the far end are still up. I'm gonna also go ahead and trim this foliage down. I think it'd be okay if I left it but while I'm in here, I thought I'd just clean it up. And there's not a bad, this isn't a bad start right here. Just hoping we can make it through. Here, just a quick peek at the ranunculus that were soaked and pre-sprouted and planted out. They're looking great, but they'll also get that frost cloth during the coldest parts of our winters here. One more thing, remember the anemones that I meant to dig up and I missed a whole row? Here they are green. Look what I spotted. Now that one has been eaten or damaged. Look who wants to play. But we do have buds on the anemones. Okay, got the rebar pounded in with a little help from my daughter. Cut these hoops down a little so they're a little bit closer to the ground. They're about, I don't know, 18 inches tall now. And then when it gets colder in the next few days, we will put on the frost cloth. I've learned over the years that these small DIY hoop houses really heat up with any sort of sun. So I'm gonna wait until we get some overcast and consistently cold days before I put the frost cloth on, like in this picture. And before long, we'll be seeing some of this stuff and I'll be out scraping it off. While I'm a girl who loves the warm temps, I have grown to appreciate the seasonality here in Iowa and the short amount of rest period during these cold days ahead. Until next time, everyone, stay warm.